Hello, I'm Dhiraj Singh for Hunar TV, and we are here to talk about a wonderful book that has been written by an amazing author who's also the co-director of the biggest literary show on the planet, the Jaipur Literature Festival. The book is called Jaipur Journals, and it looks at the lives of the artists, of the writers who come to the festival. So let's go to the author, who's Namita Gokhale. A very warm welcome, Namita.
Thank you.
The idea, the germ of the book came to you via a literary agent, Lynn Nesbitt. She suggested this. What exactly did she have in mind when she offered this book to you?
I don't know what she had in mind, because what came out was not what she had in mind, but she loved it anyway. I think maybe she had thought of a more of an exotic India kind of story, whereas I was really looking for the backstories of those thousands upon thousands of people who come there.
Let's talk about Rudrani Rana, who's the main character and very interesting character in the book. And she's actually, to me, she seems like a composite of all the authors and wannabe writers who probably come to the festival.
Rudrani Rana came to me full grown, as nasty as she is served up. Mm-hmm. But somewhere I had glimpsed one day, looking at somebody waiting outside the author's lounge in an unnamed festival, mm-hmm. I'd seen that look in that man's eyes. He wanted to be there with the famous writers, and he wasn't an imposter. He was a bright man, and possibly the novel he had hidden inside him or hidden in his bottom drawer was a good book, but he had not made it there. It's not a book about failure, and Rudrani Rana is not about failure. Right. It's just about where novels land up. And I was also deeply interested in the idea of somebody who wrote anonymous letters, mm-hmm. because I had actually encountered a spate of anonymous letters.
During the festival?
No.
Okay.
It was when I was in the Indira Gandhi National Center for the Arts. Mm-hmm. And for some reason, I got these letters which vilified somebody I was quite fond of. And they were typed out in a jumpy typewriter.
Right.
And jumpy typewriters don't exist anymore.
Mm. And maybe in government offices they do.
Well, even in government offices, perhaps. And I was so drawn and intrigued by the thought of the person who was writing these intensely malicious letters and what must be going on in her mind. So when I was taking notes for Jaipur Journals, I kept saying, anonymous letters.
In fact, one of the writers, the notes really affected was Zoya Bankotia, and she really gets unnerved by the content of the letter she's received.
The one question I get asked all the time is, why did Rudrani have to die? But
right.
I knew she had to die. She just had to. In the beginning, when I took the notes, I knew somebody had to die, and I knew it hurt me to kill her. I almost killed her, then she didn't die, but then I had to do it. And the other question that a lot of people ask me with real anger is, why did Gayatri marry Sumedh? Now, for people who haven't read the book, how do I explain this intense involvement in Gayatri's life and the feeling that I somehow, as the author, let her marry the wrong man? I'm very flattered that people are so deeply involved in the life of the characters in Jaipur Journals.
You know, anyone else writing the book would have been okay, but you are the ultimate insider of the festival. You know, you are a co-director. And did you upset a lot of people by writing this?
Not at all. No. Who could be upset, you tell me? Because the characters are entirely fictional, and I don't see any of my writers identifying with any of them. And now when people send me very flattering messages on Twitter, which I'm always delighted by, I end up asking them, who was your favorite character?
Yeah.
And it's really interesting because it is Rudrani, it is also Raju Srivastav Betab, the burglar in the Shire. Raju Srivastav Betab entered my life in a strange way. One night, I leave the lights on at night in my room because I never know when I get up to write some inspiration line, which may not look so good the next day. And I heard a creaking sound, and then I saw something was not quite right in my room. And then I saw one door was open, which led to the back courtyard. And there was a cat burglar systematically going through a very complicated set of things that he had taken outside, including my handbag, which was lying right next to my bed. So he had been around my room a bit. And instead of getting terrified and bolting the door, which would have been the normal reaction of a person with self-preservation instincts, I went up to him and asked him very politely, but in a rather Memsab voice, I said, "Aap hai kaun aur aap yahan kar kya rahe?" And he got so startled that he slid out. And I can never forget that moment when he ran out of the back door. He didn't run, he floated. He was like a ballerina.
Wow.
And I thought, this man has grace and talent, and what is he doing here going through my disappointing handbags, which are not stuffed with cash? And he was later arrested, and I felt a deep sense of empathy with him, because I do feel that in life, bade chor to pakde nahi jate, they are the ones who rule our lives through so many ways. The real sort of thefts are done out in the open.
You have taken us into the lives of people who come there, especially the authors, and especially the people on stage, the panelists. And that's a very interesting insider account which one sees through the book. And it's really, really nice for a reader to get that account. It doesn't happen at many festivals. So this is probably the first that we have seen in India where a festival has taken a sort of light and easy view of itself, not too serious and not too sort of
I am told that there have been two other novels recently out, which I didn't want to read before I wrote this, on Lit Fests. And there's Andrew Sean Greer's very famous Less. And there was another novel which I read some years ago, which was set in the Jaipur Festival. But that seemed mostly to have people getting into bed in Diggy Palace. I don't think that happens. I think everybody's too emotionally exhausted in the festival.
So will there be a Jaipur Journals part two, a sequel to this book?
I don't know the reply to this one, because whenever I say never, that usually in my perverse mind becomes an absolute reality that I will do it. But as of now, I'm writing another book and I'm deep into it, and those characters are the ones that inhabit my mind, except that a bit of Rudrani Rana lives on in me.